Hello YouTubers, this is the second part of the little project involving the build of the mini USB solar charger. I'm just literally showing you this point of view because I happen to have the charger up on a window charging, and I'm monitoring it with a Fluke 287 multimeter, which has got some logging capability. So I must say it's quite a useful little tool. I just want to introduce you into that as well. It's something I hope will add value to some of the existing and future projects that I'll be working on. The meter allows you to log what's going on in terms of voltage and current over a specific period, and you can specify the number of intervals. So it's a great tool in seeing how well a battery pack is charging or what current you're getting from a solar cell or solar panel over a period of time, which can be quite handy as opposed to trying to run back and forth and see what readings are at odd times. Anyway, so I'm going to disconnect the leads now, and we can have a closer look at the actual project itself. So I'm actually going to stop the logging, and we can have a closer look at that. I'm just going to save it. I'm going to try to show you down here, give you a closer look at the project itself. So you've seen I showed you the components in part one, and I put them together. This is still a work in progress. The battery pack actually is away. I will finally have it all actually fit around that way, is the way I plan to use it. And then I had originally thought that this project would remain closed, and I've got this the panel on the front, the top lid, and the underside. The theory was that if you're walking or backpacking, you know, it didn't matter if it swung round, you'd still get the charge going into the batteries. But as I discovered, the big benefit of this case and having the two panels, that if you don't have it kind of slung out in you in one position in the sun, if you open it up in effect into like a butterfly, you double your charging power. And I've seen that basically on this, even though these are stuck behind obviously the plastic of the case and they're sitting behind a window with fly screen, you're going to get on average 14 to 15 milliamp per cell. So you get 30 to 40 milliamp when this is folded out. So, and it charges relatively quickly. That's, I say, I'm going to confirm with this meter over here. I'm going to have a log, and we can, perhaps in part three, I'll go through the graphing and how well it does charge. I can show you on this meter. But back to this. So this is what it's going to look like. So what I'm going to do to neaten it up so it can be opened, I'm going to put a protective panel over the front here so that it can be opened up without exposing the batteries and the loose wires. So you can have it in a configuration whether open or closed, and then hopefully I'm going to try and fit in, if possible, a little hold for your USB charging cable. And so far I'm going to just demonstrate. The one main reason I built this was actually for my wife. She's going to be doing a walk, and she's going to be using a little Garmin GPS watch. It's a walk that's going to last 3 days, and this only lasts 8 hours. And this is a perfect little companion for her trip so that she can actually charge her watch while she's doing after she's each day. And so far I've seen that once this is fully charged, it'll easily charge this watch 2 to 3 times. So just again going back to the build, I'm not going to scrunch up too much, but at the bottom I've got this little Velcro piece which covers the USB port, which I put in the bottom. It's all nicely glued in and sealed up, and then obviously with this hooked over there, it prevents any dust or minor moisture going in. And I'll just show you, I'll quickly plug in the watch to show you it in action. There we go. And as you can see, the watch is now charging. And I've run a little GPS unit off this, and I say I've charged this watch multiple times, so it seems to work like a treat. The balance of the input that you get off these little 9-volt solar cells and the 4-pen light batteries seems to be quite nice. It's enough solar cell to charge the batteries that you've got in there, and the batteries seem to be more than adequate to power your normal USB electronic mobile devices. So I must say, it seems to have worked out quite well. The one interesting thing I noted in the first video that I was going to use an LED, I thought, to kind of show it charging and what have you. And what I discovered, that LED, which required a resistor in series, just to prevent it blowing, and it would be linked in parallel, it seriously dropped the amount of power coming in and the voltage, which kind of makes sense. I hadn't realized it would be as severe as it was. So I've eliminated that from the project, because it also basically drains power. If this is removed from the sun, you then start leaking power out of your batteries into that resistor. So what I intend to do, if I can fit it in nicely, I've got this neat little LCD voltage indicator. It's basically for the RC to put in remote control vehicles and what have you. It doesn't require, it uses the external power, so it doesn't require its own power source. What I hope to do, if I can fit this all in, is have it mounted in the bottom here with a push button so you can see the state of charge of your batteries. And ideally, the batteries need to be in the range of 4.8 to, let's say, 5.4, 5.5 volts is kind of the top end they charge to. And at least from this, if it's got a little push button and I can manage to get it all in, then that would give you a nice state of charge. So a little bit of a challenge, but I think I've got the room there to actually fit it in and have a nice cover plate to protect it all. And I say I'll get that all together, and we'll see what it looks like in the final video. And if people are really interested in the tools of the trade and this multimeter, I must say I've just acquired it, and it's quite a beast. The nice thing is it's very accurate. I haven't bought it for its accuracy, but more its resolution. I mean, just on the volt scale, you can see you can go to 4 decimal places, which is really great. On a small project like this, you can see very quickly whether your batteries are accumulating charge or not, because obviously they're only getting a small amount of charge. Anyway, thank you very much if you're interested. And if you're interested to see more about this meet in particular, then do leave a comment, and I will perhaps put the effort in and get a separate video on this meter. Thanks very much.